For the last 2 weeks, I've been running the RS Tech version 2 belt drive kit with standard gearing. Before that, I spent 9 months with the taller gearing setup. So how do they compare? Acceleration, fuel economy, comfort? Which gearing ratio would suit you the best? Stick around and find out. Whether you're running on a chain or a belt drive, changing the gearing ratio on your Royal Enfield 650 is surprisingly simple. From the factory, the bike comes with a standard gearing designed for balanced performance, but if you want a more relaxed ride at higher speeds, you can opt for a taller gearing, achieved by adding a tooth to the front sprocket or reducing teeth on the rear. This lowers the engine's RPMs at cruising speeds, which should, in theory, improve fuel economy. The trade-off? Slightly slower acceleration compared to standard gearing. But how much of a difference does it actually make? Let's put it to the test today, starting with a speed run.
So on the taller ratio, it really does lower the engine revs. When you're at cruising speed, it really does lower the revs. So when I'm on sixth gear now, it feels like I'm on fifth gear from before. I'm looking for that extra gear that I don't have anymore, sadly. But obviously the acceleration is a lot better. We're going to do an acceleration test in a minute anyway to test it.
Okay, so now I'm going to attempt the 0 to 100 kilometers per hour and the 0 to 120 kilometers per hour on the new RS Tech version 2 belt drive standard ratio. So it should be quicker than the last ratio I had. I did a test on that when I did a review on the Interceptor 650 and did a comparison. The only thing that I have got different today is a saddlebag and a stand. So that's gonna slow me down, maybe with a little bit of resistance, speed resistance, wind resistance.
So it wasn't that long ago I did a review, a comparison between the Interceptor and the Meteor 650, and I filmed a speed test. If you want to see that video, I'll put a link here and in the video description. I'm going to use that old footage now and compare it with this new footage today. I'm not one of those crazy people that really revs the engine before I let the clutch out. I'm just interested in everyday acceleration. So I'm going to drive the bike hard, but I'm not going to drive it stupidly hard. I'm not going to rev it till I've nearly broken the engine like I see on some speed comparison tests on the Meteor. So I'm going to ride it as I did that day, and I'll give you the results any minute. Once this road clears, it's very busy. Right, after this truck passes, I can do it. 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah, so that really felt quick. Really felt quick. I'll be interested to see that on the video myself and then compare the two videos together. Yeah, it felt really good. Really good. The only thing is, like I say, I'm in sixth gear. When I'm in sixth gear, I feel like I want to go up one more gear because I've been used to that for the last 9 months, right? So I feel like I'm a gear missing. So yeah, let's just go through the benefits of a belt drive. There are many, to be honest. On the last video, there were quite a few chain guys really dead against the belt, explaining the power loss and how much a chain is so much better. But I don't get it at all. And even when I researched on the internet, even the internet says the belt drive is more economical and more efficient at delivering power as a drive. There's no loss of heat as you do with friction on a metal chain. So I find it very good. It's very smooth. So there's the first thing. It's so smooth between gear changes. Mrs. T would always hit me on the back of the helmet between gear changes. Now she doesn't. So that proves how smooth it is. When I rode the Interceptor 650, you could see the forks dipping up and down between gear changes. That's going to lose power because of the unsmoothness of the snatch of a chain. There's none of that. There's no dipping of the forks between gears. Again, that's saving you power, more efficient. Of course, the chain lubing, right? There's no lubing to do on this chain. No oily mess, no dirty bike, no dirty fingers. So it's so much better in that respect also. Fuel economy, even though I went to the higher ratio, it was still better fuel economy than the chain. So you got the fuel economy there. Now I'm back to standard ratio. I'll reveal the figures, but I'm still better fuel economy than the chain. So yeah, it's so much better in every respect. It's designed for cruisers, I think, a belt drive, which is why Harley Davidson fit them, Indian fit them, the Kawasaki Vulcan 900, it comes as standard, and even CF Moto on that little 450 cruiser that they've made, they've put a belt drive on it. So if you're an off-road bike, certainly it's not for you, it's not your style. You don't want to get a stone in a belt, I agree. But what's the chances of getting a stone in a belt when you're a cruiser, when you're cruising on open roads? You just want the smoothness, you want the reliability, and you also want longevity in your belt. You don't want to be changing a chain every 10,000 kilometers or 10,000 miles, or whatever it is. It also depends on how well you maintain your chain, right? You have to retension it often. You have to oil it often. Yes, you do have to maintain a belt also, but it's basically a visual inspection. Every 4,000 kilometers, you just have to visually check it and put that tension gauge on it. That's all you have to do. If you do have to retension it, then it's seconds to do it. It's not a big deal. It's not a game breaker. And the biggest bonus of all is it works out cheaper in the long run. A, you're saving on fuel economy, and B, you're not paying labor expenses changing a chain and sprockets. This is designed to last between 100 and 150,000 kilometers, and it does. People report that it does on other brands. I'm not sure about this brand, obviously, but it uses the same belt, so why not? It should do, right? It should do. Oh, I've just made that light. Lucky me. I've just refueled as well, so I've got some figures for you worked out.
Here's some old footage back to one of my first rides. This was my maiden 1,600 kilometer voyage to Bangkok and back, still on the chain with a brand new bike. Bearing in mind it was city traffic, motorway traffic, and mountain roads during the end, the average consumption was 22.56 kilometers per liter, or 63.7 miles per gallon UK gallon, or 53 miles per gallon US gallon. So for a big bike, I think this was fairly good. And please bear in mind, this is a new engine, it's quite tight, so I think as it loosens up, I'm going to get better MPG also. And I certainly did. On the chain, eventually, I averaged 24 kilometers per liter. And the next figures are my last refueling on the taller gear ratio.
252.9 kilometers when I last filled up. So what do you call dim tank. Cop open cup.
252.9 kilometers divided by 9.59 liters equals 26.37 kilometers per liter, which is what we consistently got during our tour of Thailand.
So I'm going to announce my fuel figures. When I was on the chain, I was getting 24 kilometers per liter on average. When I switched to belt drive on the taller gearing, I was achieving 26 kilometers per liter consistently, even on our tour from the north of Thailand to the south, even with pillion, even with luggage, 26 kilometers per liter. So much better. Now I've gone back to stop ratio. What do you think it's going to be? What do you think?
And this is where the results have surprised me. Unless I've made a mistake over the last 2 weeks, I've worked out I'm getting, on average, 29 kilometers per liter. It really doesn't make sense on a standard ratio belt drive. It does need further testing. Stay tuned in future videos for confirmation. Discussing ride comfort today might seem unexpected, but I've encountered another surprise. Previously, with the chain drive, my Meteor's rear axle was positioned towards the back, a common scenario with a stretched chain. The taller ratio belt drive also featured a small diameter rear pulley, producing a similar effect. Now, after reverting to the standard ratio, which includes a larger diameter rear pulley, the belt length is shortened slightly, moving the rear axle forward by about 15 millimeters. This adjustment has improved ride comfort over the road undulations. Given my frequent critiques of the Meteor's ride quality in the past videos, this positive change was unexpected and personally beneficial. Now with 7,000 kilometers on the chain drive, 9,000 kilometers with the taller geared ratio belt drive, and just under 1,000 kilometers on the new version 2 standard ratio belt drive, here are my thoughts. I 100% prefer the belt drive over a chain drive. For those of you considering the RS Tech belt drive, I hope my experiences provide valuable insights. If you've already installed a belt drive kit, I'd love to hear about your fuel economy results. Special thanks to everyone who contributed on the recent Facebook poll on chain-driven fuel economy figures. Again, the average reported was 24 kilometers per liter. I'll continue to monitor and share updates over the next 300 kilometers regarding fuel efficiency. Until then, ride safe.